Holmes-Ray stress test. I'm going to pass this around. Two psychiatrists in 1967, Richard Holmes and Thomas Ray, decided to study 5,000 of their patients, or patients, not their patients, 5,000 medical patients in a hospital setting, to see if there were, if the theory they were postulating was true. They were assuming that ordinary events, and some events that are not so ordinary, when they happen to you, make you more susceptible for serious disease in the near future. So they created this test and they set out to study these 5,000 patients, and they had a almost perfect correlation in their test, so they proved it. And they published this in 1967. Look at some of these life events. The number one on the list is death of spouse. Each of these is given a ranking. If your husband or wife dies, that's...
This is changed, right?
Yeah. This is the original one. Death of spouse is the most stressful event that can happen to a human being, 100 points. If you get 300 points or more, when you add this up, you are 80% chance of becoming seriously ill in the near future. Look at some of the items on here. Look at the ones near the bottom. Christmas season. Christmas season has a ranking of 12. It is a stressful event. Vacations are stressful. Good stuff and bad stuff. Marital reconciliation, 45. Look at the ones that say 19, mortgage loan over $10,000. This is 1967. I think we need to put another zero on that. Probably mortgage rate over 100,000. Or mortgage loan under 100,000, number 36. All these kinds of things can stress us. Now, I know of no one who has yet concocted a study or a test such as this for items that might pertain to business. But if there were such a test, those items surely would include such things as cash flow problems and or huge new client, huge new customer. I suddenly have to respond. If I own a construction company and I'm selling twice as much stuff as I did before, now I've got to hire new people, that's a stressful thing. Although it's good news, but it's stressful. It's going to exhaust you somewhat because you have to do those kind of things. What other things might be on a business stress test? Well, the economy, things over which you have no control. Suppose the economy gets worse, and that's it could happen. Suppose the economy suddenly gets better. That'll be stressful too. Happy days are here again. We've got to get used to that. So all sorts of events, positive and negative, can be stressful. How are you doing with your scorekeeping? Who's got a score of 100?
252.
Who's got a score of more? Anybody got more than that?
And I was being nice.
252. Okay, that's a high score. All right. So you see where I'm getting at? It's good stuff and bad stuff that we have to respond to in some fashion. And if we have a lot of it, it can make us ill. Your stress probably has to do with complexity and time pressure. All the things you think about that have to do with your work that stress you, how many of those fall into the category they are either complex issues with complexity or issues with time pressure and deadlines? A lot of them, correct? Yeah. And that's common to all business all the time, and that's never going to change. So let's learn to adapt to those things in ways that don't kill us and don't harm us, in ways that we can skate by anyway. All right? Now, here's sources in a job, in work, of where stress could come from. It can come from any of our rocks, offerings, peoples. We know it's coming from people. We've talked about that a couple times already. Attitudes can be, or even our own attitude. I just hate what I'm doing this at this particular time in my career. I can't stand it. My attitude sucks. Well, that's stressful. It could be marketing, delivery of services, profits, and systems. I don't have systems. I've got to get some systems. That's stressful when you don't have them and you need them. So where does your stress come from? You could think about that. The more you can nail down where your stress is coming from, the more likely you'll be able to tackle those things and do something to change them a bit, make them better. Okay. So what are some of your symptoms? Because we want it to go away and never come back. And it'll never happen. Because we need some.
Yeah. Oh, man, we need a lot.
We need actually a fair amount. Yeah. Or what happened to us? We would never get out of bed in the morning. We wouldn't set goals. Wouldn't have any ambition. We wouldn't come to programs like this where we can learn to do things better. We'd give up. But we can't have too much. So it's a titration situation. We know we need this much, but not this much, and this much is not good. Here's what we do to cope. We can meditate. We can get a koi pond. And we've been talking about koi ponds for how many years? We can do yoga, other kinds of exercise. We can use self-hypnosis. We can go to see the shrink and get some therapy. We can change our diet. We can eat less sugar and reduce the caffeine or reduce the alcohol in our consumption. We can take a vacation. We can go to the video store and rent some Marx Brothers movies and laugh. I like that one. I love to laugh. My favorite programs on television are the ones that make me laugh. Now, here are some helpful tips, because I like to give you a few tips. The first tip is you can buy books and read about this. Stress Management for Dummies. And there's a lot of books around, as I said, and a lot of the books have some good stuff in them, so you can read some books. You can start drinking. I don't recommend this one, but this seems to be something that a lot of people do. So I put it on a list, have a drink. There is a reason why a lot of people, when they come home from work, have a glass of wine or a bottle of beer. It kind of relaxes them a little bit and shifts the focus from the day to the evening. But people have a lot of problems with that too, so we can't overdo it. You can get one of these. Get a stress reduction kit, bang head here. Place it on a firm surface, follow directions, repeat 2 times until you're unconscious. Yeah, knock yourself out. You can do that. Or the problem with those things is there's a futility in those things, kind of like that they are going to help you in the short term, but not the long term. Because if you knock yourself unconscious with that thing, you will wake up. And whatever is stressing you caused you to do that is still there. They don't fix the problem. The problem remains. They don't remove the stressor. The stressor is still there. And we're still impacting us and still causing us to feel certain ways we don't want to feel. So the best option is to isolate that stressor, intervene, and make it go away. Sometimes that's impossible. Many times it is possible. Many times it's possible to some degree. But if we just think we can't do anything about it, I'm just going to give up and go out in the garden and eat worms, that's not the best option. Or settle for less, that's not the best option. So the real fix is we must do the only thing that ever works long term, which is solve the problems and working on the problems. And instead of giving up, instead of settling for less, instead of feeling so overwhelmed by what it is that you say, well, I'm doomed. Because if you feel that way, you're doomed. Doomed. So we have that choice. We can focus on stress reduction techniques, and we ought to do some of that. We also ought to have another eye on what's the source and change our lives and make our lives better so that we learn how to cope. You can solve those ongoing, those pesky problems, those ones that reoccur over and over again. And we know what those are. And we should find a solution to those anyway. And we can be proactive about looking for those things and solving those things and commit ourselves to getting done, to that being done business as soon as possible, and then work on those things religiously. Input does replenish our intellectual capital and does lower our stress because it allows us to be able to deal with it more effectively. Another reason to be religious about coming to Mastermind is to replenish intellectual capital and be better armed to fight off the stressors of work and ordinary life, such as Christmas and Thanksgiving and traffic tickets and death of friends and so on and so forth. But the real fix is to get it done as soon as possible.